In a previous tutorial, I created a Tomcat 7 web application that has a servlet that returns a simple string if it was successfully accessed, and a web.xml file with a role that user is trying to access the servlet must belong to, and a basic authentication mechanism that is specified in that web.xml. And I also set up a Tomcat user in the Tomcat users.xml file, and that user has a username and a password and belongs to the role that was specified in web.xml. Now this tutorial is gonna build on the previous tutorial just mentioned, and in addition I'm gonna be covering the methods get user principle and get remote user and get auth type and is user in role of the HTTP servlet request. And also I'm gonna be covering web.xml security role and security role ref. I went ahead and created the Java Web Security Project 06, and essentially web.xml here, and the do something servlet are exact replicas of the contents of Java Web Security Project 02. Now on the do something servlet, I'm gonna start by adding a print line statement for the get remote user on the request, and this method essentially returns the name of the person that the container associates with the request. And next I'm gonna do a print line statement on what's returned by the get auth type method. And what's gonna be printed here is the value that's coming from here, from the auth method definition in web.xml. So it's gonna be basic. Next, I'm gonna print out the name that is associated with the user principal instance that I'm gonna pick up from this HTTP servlet request. So you would use user principal and the remote user, the get remote user methods, in order to do some business logic based on the information that is obtained by those methods. And I want also to do a toString method, to call the toString method on on that user principal, and print what's returned by that method. Next, I'm gonna check if this user is in the user's role, and it should be. I'll also check if that user is in an invalid role, and it should return false here. So is user in role. And now let me do a save all and go ahead and run it. So VA user, the user that I defined that is in the user's role, and the password was password. And let's see what got printed out. So the get remote user method returned VA user. The get auth type gave me back basic, and the get user principle dot get name returned ZA user, and the toString method on the user principal instance that was obtained from the get user principal method returned the user. So the username is ZA user, and the role that user is in is users. And is user in role, users returned true, and is users in role
invalid role returned false. So let me go ahead and stop the server, close the browser, and I want to also quickly show the content of Tomcat users.xml. So I have the user VA user that has a password of password and belongs to the role of users that was defined over here. Next, since I'm gonna be doing all the declarative security configuration in web.xml, I'm gonna go ahead and remove the annotation from here and go to web.xml, and let me do this first. I'm gonna put a servlet tag here, and under it I'm gonna define the servlet name, which is do something servlet, and the servlet class, which is com.ca.tutorial.do something servlet, and the servlet mapping to this URL pattern, the project name / do something servlet. And let me define the user's role in the security role over here. And I'm gonna define a new role. We're gonna call servlet user. So the role name is servlet user. And inside the servlet tag, I'm gonna define a security role ref, where I'm gonna map the servlet user to the role link of users. So what the assumption is that the developer, let's say he has a user that he's gonna be using inside the application that is called servlet user, and he knows about that user, and then when the application gets deployed, that servlet user role is gonna be linked to the user's role by the deployer. So inside the code, the developer can use that servlet user role. So let me do this. Let me check if is user enroll on the servlet user role. Save all and go ahead and run the servlet. So here we go. So request.isUserEnroll. So it is in the servlet user role. It is also, I mean, for sure, in the user's role. And if user enroll is checked against an invalid role, it's gonna give false.